Is it possible to trisect an arbitrary angle by construction? This question goes back to ancient Greece. However, the solution wasn't proven mathematically until the 19th century. What was the conclusion? What main idea was used in the proof? Let math travel. The key idea is transforming this geometry problem into an algebra problem. From a problem of actions to a problem of theory, there's an arbitrary angle. Suppose this angle has been trisected. Let's call this angle theta. The original angle becomes 3 theta. We draw a circle with a radius of 1. We see two intersection points. Draw perpendicular lines passing through two points. This is x. This is y. If we know x, we can determine 3 theta through this perpendicular line. In a similar way, knowing y would reveal theta. So, in order to trisect an angle, we essentially need to find theta from 3 theta. In other words, it's like finding y from x. Since a length represents a number, this boils down to whether we can calculate number y from number x using only construction. To do that, we need an equation connecting x and y. Can we get that? Yes! Take a look at these triangles. They're right triangles. Now, we can calculate cosine 3 theta and cosine theta. X equals cosine 3 theta and y equals cosine theta. We are expressing the lengths with algebra. Fortunately, there is a special formula linking cosine 3 theta to cosine theta, the triple angle formula. Substitute cosine 3 theta with x and cosine theta with y. The formula becomes a cubic equation in y. Now, angle trisection problem is all about finding y given x. If y could be found for any x using construction, then we could trisect any angle. But if it's not always possible, then trisection isn't always possible. So the answer lies in whether y is a constructible number or not. This length is 1. Using construction, we can add or subtract this length repeatedly. As a result, we can create natural numbers. And we can also divide this length as desired. Draw an additional line and repeat the unit length. Draw a line connecting these two points and draw parallel lines to this line. We can divide this segment into equal parts, creating any desired fraction. So far, constructible numbers are rational numbers. We can also multiply and divide numbers using construction. Using this construction method, this length represents the product AB of two numbers A and B. Using this construction method, this length represents the division B over A. Since A and B are rational, AB and B over A are also rational. So, can we create only rational numbers through construction? No! We can even construct some irrational numbers, specifically square root of rational numbers. This length is 1. This length is x, which is rational. Add two lengths, draw a perpendicular bisector. This length is divided in half. Draw a circle with a radius of this half length. Draw a line passing through this point. This triangle is a right triangle. These triangles are also right triangles, and they are all similar. If we call this length A, we get the following proportion. A becomes root x. We've constructed root x. If this length were root x, this length will be the square root of root x. By repeating this process, these lengths are also constructible numbers. But the numbers like this still can't be constructed this way. In summary, constructible numbers include rational numbers and their square roots. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of these numbers are also constructible. So, even complicated-looking numbers in this form are constructible. Now, let's wrap up the angle trisection problem. The question boils down to whether y, which satisfies this equation, is a constructible number. Solving the equation, y has this value. It's complex, but here's the key. A cube root appears. This means y may not be constructible for some values of x. For example, If the angle is 90 degrees, then x is 0, and y becomes this particular value. Since this consists of rational numbers and square roots, trisection for this angle is possible. But what about an angle of 60 degrees? In this case, x equals a half, and y turns out to include not only a cube root, but also an imaginary number. It is impossible to find y through construction. This means we can't trisect an angle of 60 degrees. So, as it turns out, there are some angles we can't trisect. In conclusion, it is impossible to trisect an arbitrary angle by construction. This result was achieved by transforming a geometric problem into an algebra problem. Such an ingenious idea. Thank you.